Is the screen is e screen visible to all? Somebody can reply.
No, sir.
Okay. No, sir.
Okay, okay. Now it may be visible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So shall we start unit number 4 now with your permission? Those have replied now.
Yes, sir. Yes. Sir.
Okay. So
yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
So unit number 4 in our syllabus is vapor power cycles. Okay. So the power, the cycles, the thermodynamic cycles, which are operated on the by using the vapors of substances, that cycles are called as power vapor power cycles. So power cycles means the cycles from which we are generating the work, or we can generate the power. So that can be called as power cycles. Okay, and this vapor power cycle is the very important unit to understand the working of thermal power units, or we can say it as steam power plants or steam power units. So the syllabus for our today's unit is classification of cycles, then vapor classification of cycles. In that there are two types of cycle we'll discuss, then vapor power cycles, then Carnot vapor power cycle, then simple Rankine cycle, and effect of operating conditions on Rankine cycle efficiency, and ideal reheat cycle is not there, only this much: effect of operating conditions on Rankine cycle efficiency. So recommended books: R.K. Rajput, Dum Kundwar, Introduction to Thermodynamics, Y.V. Sarav, and of course our notes. Okay, so this unit is very, very important. So first of all, we'll go for the classification of thermodynamic cycles. So we know that cycle. Who will define cycle now? Cycle. Who will define cycle? Or cycle means thermodynamic cycle. Anybody? Cycle. How we can define cycle? Anybody? Nobody is defining cycle. So it is a series of process. Cycle is nothing but what? It is a series of process, okay, by the virtue, by applying or by going through all the series of processes, the system is coming to the original condition, that is called as cycle. And these cycles are there, thermodynamic cycles are there, broadly classified into two categories. So according to the, there are two statements of second law. One is Kelvin-Planck statement and another is Clausius statement. And we know that Kelvin-Planck statement is used for the engines, and Clausius statement is used for refrigerators or heat pumps. Okay, so thermodynamic cycles, power, then whatever the Kelvin-Planck is there, it is heat engine means they are generating the powers. So thermodynamic cycles are mainly classified into power cycles and refrigeration cycles. So in this, again, the power cycles are again divided into mainly two categories depending on the working substance. So some power cycles, working substance is used as a steam or vapors of substances. These cycles are called as vapor power cycles. And in the power cycles only, sometimes we are using the pure gases, that is by making the combustion of the gases, then that cycles are called as gas cycles. Means whatever the gas cycles are there, so there are, again, these gas cycles are classified into two categories. Okay, IC engine cycles means internal combustion engine cycles, and external combustion engine cycle, or it is called as gas turbine cycles. So these gas cycles are classified into internal combustion engine cycles and gas turbine cycles. Then again, you are learning the subject IC engine. So IC engines, again, they are classified into two categories. One is SI engine cycles and another is CI engine cycles. Okay, so all these gas cycles are there, IC engine, internal combustion engine cycles, gas turbines or external combustion engine cycles. They are, their purpose is to absorb the heat and to generate the power. So another category that we are having interest in our lecture is the vapor power cycles. And what are the vapor power cycles are there? Basically, there are two types of vapor power cycles are there, or there are two categories of vapor power cycle. One is Carnot vapor cycle and another is Rankine vapor power cycle. Carnot, obviously, it is the name of scientist, therefore it is called as, either name is known as Carnot. And another is Rankine. So Rankine, scientist Rankine has developed this cycle, hence it is called as Rankine vapor power cycle. Then there are some modifications in the Rankine cycle as per the need of the industry. And that cycles we can take into consideration, and that cycles are ideal heat cycle, ideal regenerative cycles. So these are the vapor power cycles: Carnot cycle, Rankine cycle, ideal heat cycle, and ideal regenerative cycles. Then here in our syllabus, we are only focusing on these vapor power cycles: Carnot cycle, Rankine cycle, ideal regenerative cycle. And refrigeration side, again there are two cycles. Again, depending on the working substance used in the refrigeration cycles. So refrigeration cycles are again classified into, in that case, depending on the working substance used, vapor cycles and air cycles. So vapor cycles means the vapor power cycle means the cycles, refrigeration cycles, in which vapors of substance or refrigerants are used, that are called as vapor refrigeration cycles. And again, they are classified into two categories. One is by using which mechanism we are using in that particular cycles. So one is vapor compression refrigerant cycle, and another is vapor absorption refrigeration cycle. So you might have studied this subject in your diploma curriculum as in the final year or in the last year of our engineering. You may studying these details, refrigeration cycles, then gas cycles also there. One subject maybe in the third year you are going to learn, that in that we are going to detail study we are gas cycles, or at least one chapter is there in gas turbine cycles. So that we are going to learn in details. But now we are going to focus on the vapor power cycle. So vapor compression refrigeration cycle is most commonly used. Whatever the refrigerators are there, we are using at our home, some air conditioners are there. So these are generally working on the vapor compression refrigerant cycle. It is a popular cycle. It is called as VCC, vapor compression refrigerant, vapor compression cycle, VCC. Okay, another is there vapor absorption, rarely used. COP is less, coefficient of performance. But again, for some where the pollution problem is there, where refrigerant now we are due to this ozone depletion layer, so generally we are going to concentrate on the vapor absorption refrigerant cycle, because these are natural free or green energy, green type of cycles are there, green energy, because less harmful these cycles are there. Okay, and air cycles, again Joule cycle is there, Breton cycles are there. So in detail we are going to, so vapor power cycles, vapor cycle and air cycle, vapor compression, vapor absorption, air cycle, Joule cycle and Breton cycle. Okay, now henceforth we will concentrate on the vapor power cycle. Anybody is have understood these thermodynamic cycles, anybody having doubt, etc., so that we'll continue. You can write message box. Anybody of you having doubt? No problem. Good. At least write message so that I can get no doubt, sir. Okay, very good. Very good. Nikhil Pawar. Anybody? Only two are having no problem. Others are having problem? No problem, sir. Okay. Rahul, here. Continue, sir. Thank you. ओके ठीक है देन मेन इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. ओके तो देन वी आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग ऑन नाउ वेपर पावर साइकिल्स. तो ऑलरेडी आई हैव डिफाइंड द वेपर पावर साइकिल्स, द पावर साइकिल्स इन विच द वर्किंग सब्सटेंस यूज्ड आर एज वेपर्स ऑफ सब्सटेंस इज कॉल्ड एज वेपर पावर साइकिल्स. तो दीज थर्मल साइकिल्स आर कॉल्ड एज वेपर पावर साइकिल एंड वेपर पावर साइकिल्स आर कार्नोट वेपर पावर साइकिल एंड अनदर इज रैंकिन, या आर ए एन के आई एन ई, रैंकिन, रैंकिन वेपर पावर साइकिल. तो देर आर टू वेपर पावर साइकिल्स आर देर, वन इज कार्नोट वेपर पावर साइकिल एंड अनदर इज रैंकिन वेपर पावर साइकिल. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज कार्नोट वेपर साइकिल. तो कार्नोट वेपर पावर साइकिल इज एन हाइपोथेटिकल साइकिल और इट इज कॉल्ड एज आइडियल साइकिल. इट इज कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ टू रिवर्सिबल आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेसेस एंड टू रिवर्सिबल आइसेंट्रोपिक प्रोसेसेस. तो कार्नोट साइकिल एज वी नो दैट रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेसेस आर वेरी आइडियल एंड वेरी फ्यू प्रोसेसेस इन द यूनिवर्स आर द रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेसेस. सो इट इज एन हाइपोथेटिकल साइकिल एंड एज इट इज कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेसेस सो साइकिल इज ऑल्सो वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू ऑपरेट रियलिटी इन द रियलिटी. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट कार्नोट साइकिल एंड दिस साइकिल इज रिमेन्ड ओनली ऑन द पेपर. सो दिस डेरिवेशन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड फॉर जनरल कार्नोट साइकिल बट हियर वी आर कंसिडरिंग इट एज ए कार्नोट पेपर साइकिल. सो दिस साइकिल इज ऑल्सो कंसिडर्ड एज आइडियल वेपर पावर साइकिल. देन अगेन एज इट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ ऑल फोर रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेसेस सो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू अचीव आइसोथर्मल हीट एडिशन, आइसोथर्मल हीट रिजेक्शन एंड देयर फोर दिस साइकिल रिमेंड ऑन द पेपर और रिमेंड एज ए ड्रीम साइकिल ओनली. सो देर इज देयर फोर रैंकिन आफ्टरवर्ड्स मॉडिफाइड दिस साइकिल. नाउ वील डायरेक्टली गो टू स्कीमेटिक ऑफ दिस साइकिल. सो कॉम्पोनेंट्स रिक्वायर्ड फॉर दिस साइकिल्स आर, now this is a steam power plant so you have learned, so it is only boiler is there. So already you are now learning the unit boiler or completely learn, you were learned the unit performance of boiler. Everybody know boiler means it is a device, closed vessel device which generates the steam at constant pressure. So steam is at constant pressure is generated from the boiler and this steam contains at point number one it is coming out from the boiler. And this steam contains high amount of enthalpy. This steam is having higher thermal energy. So high energy, high thermal energy. And obviously, enthalpy is going to be more. Heat content is going to be, enthalpy means heat content is going to be more. And pressure is also more. So this steam is supplied to a device. It's called as a steam turbine. So steam turbine is again one of the closed device where what we are doing. We are obtaining, we are getting the work from this particular steam turbine where expansion of that steam means higher pressure steam, higher enthalpy steam is takes place and whatever the heat is loosed in the steam turbine is converted into work and the remaining heat is having low pressure, low temperature, low enthalpy is supplied to the condenser. So this condenser, what it will do? It will condense that particular steam, okay, and whatever the substance we are getting, the outlet of the condenser. Now here in the Carnot cycle, now we are going to see the PV diagram and HS diagram. So in the condensation process is not going to be complete. Okay, we'll see afterwards. But therefore, this condensate means the mixture coming from the condenser or outlet working substance coming from the condenser is called as condensate. So now here condensate is consisting of some liquid is there because we are not going for the complete condensation, some liquid and some vapor. It is consisting of some mixture of some vapor and some liquid. Some vapor is remained in the vapor stage only because condensation is not, we are not allowing complete condensation. If complete condensation is there, then only liquid will come from the condenser in the form of condensate. Then this condensate mixture of liquid and vapor is going to be supplied to a compressor, okay, and this compressor is now afterwards it will compress this particular mixture of vapor and liquid and it is supplied to the boiler. This was the proposed cycle by the SADI Carnot. okay, and therefore it is called as a Carnot cycle. As it consisting of four reversible processes, it is considered an ideal cycle. Now, here process 1 to 2 is there. Now we have given the names. What are the boiler is there? So boiler to steam turbine, that 1 to 2 boiler. Sorry, 2 point will be here, not there. So 2 point will be here. Here it will be. So 2 point. So we can set it as a 2. Okay. Then 1 to 2 boiler here. 1 to 2 here. Here steam expansion of steam through the turbine, isentropic expansion. Okay. Then 2 to 3 is what? 2 to 3 condensation process. So it is again isothermal heat rejection. Means condenser means steam is losing that heat into the condenser. Isothermal heat rejection in condenser. Then 3 to 4 is there. Isentropic compression, exactly reverse of turbine. Isentropic compression in a compressor. And then afterwards 4 to 1 is there. It is isothermal heat addition in boiler. Isothermal heat addition in boiler. That is 4 to 1. So these are the four processes. 1 to 2, that is happens in the steam turbine. Isentropic expansion of steam in the steam turbine. Then 2 to 3 is isothermal heat rejection in condenser. Then 3 to 4, isentropic compression of condensate in compressor. And 4 to 1, isothermal heat addition in boiler. Okay. Then PV diagram of Carnot cycle. Then PV diagram is consisting of what? Now this is called a saturation curve. So we have learned this saturation curve in our unit number 2. So this point is there. It is called as a critical point. Okay. So this will be the saturated liquid line. This is a saturated vapor line. And what are these two lines where it meet? That point we are calling it as a critical point. Okay. So 4 to 1 means here on this side liquid line, if any point is there on the liquid line, so it is called as what? Here liquid, and where on this side it is called as what? Vapor points. So 4 to 1 is there. We are considering first of all 4 to 1. So isentropic heat addition. So in the boiler, pressure is remaining as a constant. So therefore, pressure, as it is P versus V, pressure is there on the y-axis and volume is there on the x-axis. Therefore, pressure is remaining constant. So it is a constant pressure. Okay. Then 4 to 1 means liquid water is converting into what? Vapor. So this is completely vapor. So we are considering as a dry steam is there. Okay, dry steam is there. And afterwards 1 to 2, isentropic expansion in steam turbine. So steam turbine expansion means pressure is goes on decreasing. Therefore, pressure is goes on decreasing. And as pressure is goes on decreasing, volume is goes on increasing. So 1 to 2 is like this. So a curve like this. So this is the expansion curve on PV diagram. Okay. So 1 to 2 is isentropic expansion in steam turbine. Where in which device is happening? That is also very important. So 1 to 2 is a isentropic expansion in steam turbine. Then 2 to 3 is the what? Isothermal heat addition is there. Now isothermal heat rejection. Again, during this curve, temperature is remaining constant because it is phase change process from this to this. From this to this, it is going to be phase change process is there, and therefore here it will be pressure is remaining constant. So isothermal heat rejection, temperature remaining constant. And 3 point, because here we are getting point number 4. Therefore, this have to have this particular isentropic compression, because we have to come compression means pressure we have to increase, and at the same time when we are increasing the pressure, volume should get decreased. And therefore, when we have to end the expansion here at point number 4, we have to start. Sorry, when we have to end the compression at point number 4, we have to start compression here only. Not here. If you start from here, this will go like this. So therefore, it will go outside this curve. Therefore, this compression, if you want to end here, then definitely wait. How to start in this region only? In this region means this region is consisting of mixture. Means point number 3, 2, they are not completely liquid. They are not completely vapor. But what are there? What are these points? So these are only mixture, means some part of liquid, some part of vapor. So point number 3, as it is closer to liquid line, so it is consisting of maximum liquid and less vapors. And point number 2 is there, it is closer to vapor line, it will consisting of anybody? Point number 2 is closer to vapor line. Anybody understood this steam tables? Point number 2 is nearer to vapor line, therefore it is maximum content will be, anybody? Message box unmute and vapor. You can tell vapor, correct. It is consisting of maximum part will be vapor and less part of liquid, but in the mixture region they are existing, therefore it is consisting of mixture, liquid plus vapor, some liquid, some vapor, here also some liquid, some vapor, and therefore this condensation is not complete. Means at point number 3, if this is condenser process is there, actually final condensation means what? Condensation means the process in which vapor, all vapors will should convert into liquid, but as there is a restriction that we have to maintain the cycle inside this particular curve only, so therefore point number 3 cannot come at point number 3, otherwise it will come to this outside the saturation curve. And our isothermal condition outside this vapor, only during this curve temperature remaining constant, outside this temperature there is a sensible heat, temperature is having chance to here increase or decrease, and therefore here we say that point number 3 here it is coming in the mixed region, means condensation is not complete. When we say condensation is complete, when point number 3 will appear or it will come on this, where this water the here cursor is there, plus type of cursor is there, I'm showing, is visible to you. So this here, if this cursor is here at this point, saturated liquid, then condensation will complete. Therefore condensation is not complete. Okay, now TS diagram, same curve, saturated liquid line, critical point, and saturated vapor line. So 4:1 again boiler temperature. Now it is temperature versus entropy. Here diagram was pressure versus volume. Okay, now 4:1 here isothermal means temperature remaining constant, and within this curve only temperature remaining constant. Here temperature is increasing, here temperature, here also temperature is changing. So 4:1 isothermal heat addition in boiler, 1:2 here isentropic expansion in steam turbine, 2:3 isothermal heat rejection in condenser, therefore temperature remaining constant, and this is isentropic process, isentropic expansion, isentropic compression constant, S1 is equal to S2 or S3 is equal to S4, isentropic compression, isentropic expansion 1:2, isentropic compression 3:4, 4:1 isothermal heat addition in boiler, 2:3 isothermal heat rejection in condenser. But point number 3 again it shows that no complete condensation. Okay, then here we have to calculate the efficiency of Carnot cycle. Everybody understood these diagrams, PV diagram and TS diagram, then schematic of Carnot cycle. Anybody having doubt, questions? If no questions, you don't waste time. If you know nothing is there, you can message box, message in the message box, so that I can get some that you are listening, you are on the right, I am on the right track, that kind of confidence I will get. Otherwise I will start my your habituated practice. What that practice, that is what I will ask some names, and so Nikhil Pawar, write message box, otherwise don't waste time in this now, because we want to complete our syllabus without any problem. No problem, sir. Only Nikhil. Okay, Nikhil Pawar, no problem, sir. Others understood, sir. Krishna Mali, good. Others, you can reply fast so that others, I am teaching from this end and you are watching. Okay. Okay. Then, okay. Then efficiency of Carnot cycle. So efficiency of Carnot cycle is nothing but it is defined as ratio of efficiency. It is engine, and engine is nothing but what? It is power generation. Output will be definitely work obtained, and input will be heat supplied. Okay. Therefore, eta Carnot is equal to efficiency of Carnot cycle is defined as ratio of work obtained from the cycle to the total heat supplied. Therefore, mathematically we say that eta Carnot is equal to here work obtained divided by heat supplied. Therefore, eta Carnot is equal to here heat supplied. Now, work obtained is equal to what? Here it will be work obtained. Where we are obtaining the work? Here in the steam turbine process. Okay, or it is Q1 heat reject supplying. We are supplying heat here Q1. Okay, and here we are rejecting the heat. And whatever the difference is there, so means if you go for the schematic, so here if you consider this as a source. So what is source? Source is nothing but what? From which we are getting the heat. And that is nothing but boiler. So source of the cycle where temperature is high, so it is nothing but what? Boiler. So from boiler we are getting the thermal energy. Okay, it is, this let us consider this as a Q1 or Q supplied. That instead of that QS here, we consider that heat supplied QS. And this is our turbine. In heat engine is nothing but what? Steam turbine. And from this steam turbine, we are getting the work. And some amount of heat is going to be rejected. Where it is going to be rejected? To the sink. Okay, sink. Okay. Let us consider this temperature is T2. Let us consider this temperature as a T1. Okay. And sink in the timber in this case is where we are rejecting heat. It is a through the medium. We can atmosphere only or condenser, we can say. So boiler as a heat source and sink device will be the condenser. So eta Carnot is equal to what? Eta Carnot is equal to what? Work obtained W divided by heat supplied US. So this we want to calculate. Okay. And therefore is equal to eta Carnot is equal to W means what? Work obtained. Nothing but what? If you apply the first law of thermodynamics, incoming is equal to outgoing. What is incoming? QS is incoming. And what is outgoing? W is outgoing. Heat rejected is also outgoing. Therefore, this W coming as QS minus QR. If you transfer this to this end, so W is equal to QS minus QR. So heat rejected will be QS minus QR divided by QS. Okay. So, but these are isothermal heat addition is what? Isothermal process. So, if you go through this slide, so this is a isothermal heat addition process. And isothermal heat addition process, what will happen? Here, dS is equal to integration of dQ by T. Therefore, dS is equal to temperature remaining constant. And dQ is equal to total heat supplied QS. So, delta S is equal to 1 by T. into QS. Therefore, QS is equal to T into D delta S. So what is that here? Here, dS is equal to integration of dQ by the entropy definition of entropy change. So dS is equal to integration of dQ by T. So if you cancel the integration sign, it will become delta S is equal to, because 1 by T temperature remaining constant, isothermal heat addition. Only for isothermal heat addition, we can take this temperature outside. So 1 by T into total in dq is nothing but total heat supplied qs. Therefore qs is equal to T into delta S, means temperature at which heat is here supplied into entropy change during that process. And here heat, same thing as heat is going to be okay, same thing is there, QS minus QR. So QR is also heat rejection at constant temperature. So therefore here as this process is heat reject constant temperature, isothermal heat addition is there, therefore it is called as QS is called as what, temperature T1 into change in entropy during that process. Here final entropy will be S4 and initial entropy will be S1, so change of entropy will be S1 minus S4, because S1 and S4 here if we go for this diagram, so process will start from 4 to 1, so entropy change will be S1, so we will defining it as here S, entropy change as a S1, this is S4, S2 and S3. So therefore S1 minus S4, similarly we can say it will be QR is equal to anybody, temperature is a T2 at which heat is rejected, T2 into here what is the condensation process is there, condensation is what, S2, maximum is S2 minus S3. So here S2 minus S3. Okay, now if you calculate, want to calculate this eta Carnot, then put this into your substitution. Or I am having, so this is a QN boiler condenser W, QS is equal to, okay, S1 is now here, otherwise I'll write, no problem. Eta Carnot is equal to T1 into bracket S1 minus S4. Now here only we'll write here, as if you see the figure, so S1 is equal to S2 because entropy isentropic process, this S1 is equal to S2 and S3 is equal to S4, therefore heat rejection will coming as S2 is equal to S1, we have to put, and S4 is equal to S3, sorry, S2 minus S3, S3, S3 is equal to S4. So here it will become what? T2 into bracket S2 is equal, because S1 and minus S4, because S1 is equal to S2 because isentropic expansion, and S3 is equal to S4 because of isentropic processes. Okay. Therefore, this eta Carnot will become T1 minus into S1 minus S4. Similarly, minus T2 into again S1 minus S4 divided by supplied will be T1 into bracket S1 minus S4. So this S1 minus S4, if you take common, okay, it will from numerator and denominator it will get cancelled. Now here derivation is there. Eta Carnot is equal to T1 minus T2 into S1 minus S4, T1 into S1 minus S4, and it will get cancelled, S1 minus S4, and therefore Eta Carnot will become T1 minus T2 divided by T1, or we can say here in this case 1 minus T2 divided by T1. So here also we say that efficiency is a function of temperature only. efficiency is function of what? Temperature only. So therefore, heat work obtained, heat supplied will be QS minus QR. Heat supplied is equal to, during isothermal process, QS is equal to TdS. Heat supplied equal to QS T1 into bracket S1 minus S4. Heat rejected is equal to again T2 into bracket S2 minus S3. But S2 is equal to S2 minus S3. S2 is equal to S3, and S1 is equal to S2 because isentropic processes. Their heat rejected is coming as T2 into bracket S1 minus S4, and finally we are getting the equation that what T1 minus T2 divided by T1 or 1 minus T2 upon T1. Means similar to Carnot cycle, Carnot vapor cycle efficiency is also function of two temperatures. This one is heat addition temperature and another is heat rejection temperature. Other Carnot cycle efficiency, this does not depend on any other factor, whatever the fluid is there, whatever the fuel is there, but it only depends on the two temperature. One is what? Carnot, one is in temperature of heat addition and another is temperature of heat rejection. And therefore, now you have understood this efficiency of Carnot cycle, understood Carnot cycle, everything. Anybody have doubt, etc.? Message box. Or any doubt, you want to repeat something, not understood this, that, I will explain now in a second. So efficiency of Carnot cycle is function of two temperatures. One is temperature of heat addition T1 and another is temperature of heat rejection T2. Anybody have doubt, etc.? Message box. No, sir. Krishna Mali, I am happy with Krishna. Yeah, he's active. Okay. Ajay Gauri understood. Another. Okay. Raymond, continue, sir. Tejasri Dongre, no, sir. No, sir means not understood. Tejasri. No problem or no, sir? Not understanding.
No problem, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Now, here eta Carnot is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1. And it is a function of only two temperatures. Now, what are the limitations of Carnot cycle? Now, first limitation is there that superheating is not possible because of isothermal heat addition of boiler. We see that here, if we want superheating of the steam, therefore point number one will not be lie on this vapor curve. Where it should be what? It should go like this, here inside, outside this curve. Superheating means this region is called what? Superheating. Where is I am here changing the cursor, I am highlighting the cursor. So this region is called as what? This region is called as what? Superheating region. So if we want to make this point number one in the superheating region, then point number one should be here. And here the isothermal condition will not be followed. Therefore, first limitation of the Carnot cycle is there that superheating is not possible because of which process? Isothermal heat addition. If it is isobaric process, it can be possible. But due to isothermal heat addition process, here superheating is not possible. These limitations are very, very important because yes, Carnot cycle is a dream cycle, but it is giving some idea about generating the power, but some limitations are there. That limitations everybody have to understand. Then second limitation of Carnot cycle is there that condensation is not complete, or we can, because we know that condensation point number three, because of again isothermal heat addition, because to have the complete condensation, this point number four should go outside. And if it's coming outside, then isothermal condition of heat addition will not be satisfied. Therefore, this point number four has to be in the this particular saturated liquid line only, or it should be binded by this curve only. Okay. Therefore, point number four is in the saturated liquid line. And therefore, here condensation is also because and to have this point number 4 here and to have isothermal compression condition from 3 to 4 this point number 3 have to be in the mixture region it should not be here if it is here it is rasta pure complete condensation manun ha kay jala apla ha asa curve it point number 4 it ala asta ani ha kay jala asta apla here mhanje it will not satisfy the condition of isothermal heat addition therefore condensation is not complete or it is called as partial condensation means partial condensation means what and after the condensation process it will not contain pure liquid it may consisting of some part of vapor and some part of liquid now due to incomplete condensation baga due to incomplete condensation compressor has to deal because afterwards this mixture is going to point number 3 we are getting here but this point number 3 the in, it is processed in compressor means compressor have to deal the mixture of what liquid and vapor and asa this kind of compressor asha paddhatiza compressor tyavis tar navtas aaj tagat pan ajun kasla tayar zalel nahi due to incomplete condensation compressor has to deal the mixture of liquid and vapor and such kind of compressor is not yet available कार्नोट सायकलच्या काळात कार्नोटच्या काळात तर नव्हताच नव्हता आणि आताही तो नाहीये म्हणजे देर इज टू कॉम्प्रेस प्युअर लिक्विड वी आर युजिंग एनीबडी तर आपल्याला लिक्विडचं कॉम्प्रेशन करायचं असेल त्याचं प्रेशर वाढवायचं असेल तर आपण काय वापर करतो एनीबडी बघू तुमचं डिप्लोमा नॉलेज काय वापरतो आपण अनम्यूट ऑर मेसेज बॉक्स बघू कोण हुशार आहे आपल्यात लिक्विड जर प्युअर आपल्याला कॉम्प्रेशन करायचं असेल किंवा त्याचं प्रेशर वाढायचं असेल तर आपण काय वापरतो कुठला डिवाइस वापरतो पंप गुड दीप्ती कदम व्हेरी गुड ओके सो ओनली दीप्ती हॅज आन्सर्ड सो दीप्ती विल कन्सिडर एज अ गुड स्टुडंट हा सो पंप टू यूज द टू कॉम्प्रेस द प्युअर लिक्विड we are using pump as a device and to compress pure gas or air we are using compressor but mixture we are never going so in the pump we never desire air or gaseous particles and in compressor we never desire any kind of liquid materials therefore there to compress pure liquids we are using pumps and to compress pure gases or ideal gases here we are considering we are using compressors and such kind of compressor which will mixture it will compress is not yet available so therefore whatever the Carnot has suggested this cycle because of that this limitation here it is remained on paper asa compressor tayar zala then it his cycle may be possible and has compressor has to deal the vapor the size of compressor and then other theoretical limitation vapor asliamule tyaza what the size of compressor will be more because compressor liquid is having less volume than the vapor and therefore compressor has to deal the vapors and size of compressor will be in unnecessarily increased okay
check
guys
ha
ha tumhala tumhala mahit asnar yada okay integrity
mahit aapla thik aapla mi responsible
As compressor increases, more work input decreases the efficiency of plant. Work ratio of plant is also decreases. The compression and expansion process are assumed also isentropic. But to friction present in the compressor real turbines means isentropic process will not be there but as compression and expansion processes are assumed isentropic but due to friction present compressor madhe friction aste then turbine madhe friction aste tyamule these processes will not be isentropic okay so as compressor size increase zalyamule the size of compressor increases size of compressor increase zalyamule the work input jast jate ani efficiency will decrease these are some theoretical 4 and 5 are theoretical limitations but practical limitations are these superheating is not possible, condensation is not complete. Due to incomplete condensation, compressor has to deal mixture of liquid, and such kind of compressor which will compress the mixture of liquid and vapor is not yet available. Compressor has a due to the vapor, therefore compressor size increase. The asil tar tayar dhala compressor tar, the compressor size increase, here work input increase, efficiency will decrease. Then compression and expansion process are assumed isentropic, but in real case there is a friction in compressor, there is friction in turbine, and therefore these processes cannot be isentropic. Okay, then simple Rankine cycle, everybody understood this, and therefore as these limitations are there and as this compressor is there, so this Carnot vapor power cycle cannot be used in practically. Ha fakt paper rahila ha use karta ra nahi. Anybody having doubt about this Carnot cycle? Carnot cycle samajhne mein kono adchan? Anybody of you, Carnot cycle kai? Anybody having problem? No problem. Mali Atharv Ajay Gowdy, no problem. Okay then, simple Suryakant Dilwar, no problem. Okay, so Rankine cycle, shall we go for? Now as there are these many limitations, here we are switching over to the another cycle, is called as what? Carnot Rankine cycle. So simple Rankine cycle. So Rankine has replaced, now as these limitations are there due to isothermal processes, therefore Rankine smartly replaced these two isothermal processes by only isobaric processes. So he was suggesting that instead of isothermal processes, if we go for isobaric processes, then this cycle may be possible. And Rankine, after observing the cycle of Carnot, limitations of Carnot cycle, he only changed that two isothermal processes of Carnot cycle, he has replaced by isobaric processes, and he made the cycle practically possible. And whatever nowadays thermal power plants are there, steam power plants are there, so these are working on this simple Rankine cycle. So Rankine has replaced the two isothermal processes of Carnot cycle by isobaric processes. Is now it consisting of four processes, two are isobaric and two are isentropic. Compressor of Carnot cycle is replaced by pump, because of isobaric condition the condensation will be complete, and if condensation is complete, there is a pure liquid we are getting from condenser, and that to compress that pure liquid we are using pump. Okay, and only change is there now, no, only change is there that instead of compressor we are using pump for the Rankine cycle. Why? Because after condensation is complete and we are getting pure liquid, and due to that we are using pump. Okay, then four schematic devices required for this particular Rankine cycle is boiler, okay, then afterwards steam turbine, then condenser, and then afterwards pump. Okay, boiler is a 4-to-1 process, isothermal, now isobaric heat addition, here it is not isothermal, isobaric heat addition. So these are MCQs they are going to ask, because our examination is on the based of on the MCQs. Therefore they will ask which isothermal heat addition process is replaced by dash dash process in Rankine cycle. So it is anybody isobaric. So these limitations means these processes we should understand formally, we should note it confidently, and we should remember at the time of examination confidently. So boiler 4-to-1, isobaric heat addition in boiler, steam turbine as usual, isentropic expansion in steam turbine. Okay, then 2 to 3 isobaric heat rejection in condenser, and 3 to 4 isentropic compression in pump. Instead of that, we can say here it will be compressor. Now PV diagram. Now PV diagram, desaturated curve. So this is where this is going to be there. This is critical point. So this will be what? This region, this line will be here. This line, highlighted line, this will line will be where I am forwarding or I am moving the cursor, triangular cursor. This will be liquid line. So this will be what? Here, this will be saturated vapor line, and this is a critical point. So 4 to 1. Now 1 point we will consider dry saturated steam. Okay, so let us consider that boiler is generating dry and saturated steam. So 1 to 2 will be heat isentropic compression in steam turbine. Point number 2 we are getting in the mixed region, and these 2 to 3 here we are going for condenser, and this condensation is complete. Therefore we are getting at point number 3, because we want complete condensation. Point number 3 we are getting complete condensation, pure liquid, and this pure liquid we are compressing in the pump isentropically, and we are getting point number 4 here, because we want only isobaric heat rejection. So entire here we say that pressure is remaining constant. So point number 4 we can bring here, and we can go for this isentropic compression line. Okay, and there 4 to 1 it is a boiler process, isobaric heat addition in boiler. 1 to 2 isentropic expansion in steam turbine, isentropic heat is it visible? Screen visible? Somebody can
reply. Yes, sir.
Good. So 3 to 4 is isentropic compression in pump. So point number 4 is coming here, but as we are maintaining the constant pressure condition, here also as we are maintaining constant pressure condition. So therefore, let it be the point number 4 it should go outside, because if it is isothermal condition, point number 4 should be here only. But as it is isobaric condition, the point number 4 can be come here outside this curve. Therefore, condensation is get complete. So this is a diagram, PV diagram, 4 to 1. This subcooled liquid, we say. This is a subcooled liquid. Then it is liquid. And then the point number 1 will be the dry saturated steam. So liquid is converting into vapor in the boiler. That high enthalpy, high heat fluid steam is expanded isentropically in steam turbine. Okay, then we are getting the work done from the steam turbine, and as we are less pressure, less enthalpy steam is here, we are getting at point number 2, and this less enthalpy, less pressure steam we are passing through the condenser, it get condensed, and what will happen here to point number 3, we are getting pure liquid, and from pure liquid what we'll do here, 3 to 4 isentropic compression. Then here, as we are getting this particular this is our TS diagram. So point number, this is our this is our 4 to 1 point is there. 4 to 1 is isothermal, isobaric heat addition, because during this curve, phase change, temperature remaining constant. Superheating temperature may increase, or temperature is going to be increased. And here also, temperature goes on increase. So this is a constant pressure line on the TS diagram. So we'll go for presentation here. So I will. So we'll go for TA diagram. So I will again repeat, this is a saturated liquid line. This is a critical point. This is our saturated vapor. Let us consider this. So this is a critical point. We will write Cp. This is saturated liquid line. This is vapor line. Okay. Let us consider that boiler is generating. So this is our pressure line. So this is, this should be here marked with very faint line. But no more for me, it is not possible. So this is a boiler where the we can say that is a boiler pressure and heat addition. This is a on TA diagram. This is a constant pressure line. Whatever the pressure is there in the boiler, so it, we can call it as a pressure in boiler. It is called as P boiler. So this pressure is remaining constant. So, so on TA diagram, this is the nature of constant pressure line. This is the nature of constant pressure line. At the same time, another device is there in our where the constant pressure condition is there. This will be pressure in the condenser. So remember that maximum pressure is always in the boiler. And lowest pressure is in the condenser. And this is nature of, again, constant pressure line in the condenser. Now, let us consider that the boiler is generating dry and saturated steam. Dry means it will not contain any liquid particle, water particle. And therefore, point number one is there. It is going to be here. Afterwards, it is steam turbine. Here, its expansion of that steam will take place isentropically. Therefore, as it is entropy is there on the y-axis, therefore, point number 1 to 2 is there. It happens in the steam turbine. Okay. Then 2 to 3, as we know that complete condensation is possible, this is, it happens in the condenser. This device is called a condenser. Okay. And this will be point number 3. Okay. And then 3 to 4, isentropic compression. This is a condenser pressure to boiler pressure. So where this pressure is matching or it is intersecting this line, boiler pressure line, so this will be our point number 4. And this process happens in the pump. Okay. So this is our heat addition in boiler. This is now sensible heat. Water, the water is there. So this water is up to saturation temperature. This temperature is called what? T saturation. So it is heated up to saturation temperature. This it is called as sensible heat. This is our latent heat where the phase change is there. And during phase change, temperature remaining constant. But afterwards, up here outside the curve, only pressure is remaining constant. Temperature is not. Okay. And this is superheated zone. So this is our 4-to-1 process. Heat addition. Sensible heat addition plus latent heat, and if it is superheated steam is there plus superheat, this kind of 4-to-1 process will be there. Everybody understood this? Okay. Then 4-to-1. This is our dry saturated steam. If the steam is wet steam, what will be our cycle? What will be change? Anybody? What will be change in that case? If steam will be the wet steam generated by boiler, then what will be changed? Anybody? Boiler it me, you are not talking. I want this kind of interactive class. Physically class. If such kind of situation is there, I am getting dull. You should talkative students. Means talkative means same. Sir, not understood, sir. Like this also, I have no problem. But this kind of real feedback or real, so that teacher will get little bit confidence. So if the steam is wet steam, only change is there that point number one will not be on the dry line, vapor line. It should be here. It should be here. Otherwise, cycle will remain same. So this is condenser pressure. So this will have to these conditions. Only cycle we have to make dark, as I would. Other things we have to make it as a faint.
Hello. आता काय झालं बरं व्यवस्थित. हाँ. आता ती म्हणते आता काय झालं गेलं. बरे वाटते का आता बरं वाटते ना आता म्हणजे जेवण वगैरे जाते का टाइम केलं और पॉझिटिव्ह आला ती चेस्ट रिपोर्ट मे तुमचा हे दाखवते दुसरा रिपोर्ट पॉझिटिव्ह दाखवते हां काय हां दुसरा रिपोर्ट पॉझिटिव्ह दाखवते जरा दुसरा रिपोर्ट पॉझिटिव्ह दाखवते म्हणून ठेवलंय असं दे त्याचं काय नाही तुम्हाला बरं वाटतंय ना आता जेवण वगैरे जाते का टाइम व्यवस्थित तरी पण जरा जात भूक लागते की नाही तुमचा प्रॉब्लेम होता ती भूक लागते की नाही अहो तिथे पहिल्या घरी गेल्यावर तर कुठे लागत नव्हती तुम्हाला भूक त्यामुळे आपण बघतो मी आज बोलून हा बघतो बोलून डॉक्टर बघतो बोलून डॉक्टरांशी बर हा ठीक बघतो बोल बर ठीक ऑक्सिजन लेवल वर चांगली आहे
हॅलो दिस इज सॉरी सम इम्पॉर्टंट फोन होता So this boiler pressure, this is a condenser pressure. And then point number one, if it is a wet steam is there, then point number one will not be on this vapor line or it will not be on liquid line. It will be on this thing, one point here. And this wet steam will be there. One to two will be there. It is going to be steam turbine. Okay. Then two to three is there. It is going to be condensation complete condensation we are getting in the Rankine cycle is condenser we say and then afterwards pressure increasing from condenser pressure to boiler pressure so this will be 3 to 4 this happens in pump You have to make the practice of these diagrams, okay? And this is 4-to-1 entire process. This will be this plus this entire process will be heat addition in boiler. So we can say it as this entire process is heat addition in boiler. Okay, so this will be boiler 4-to-1 process. Okay, so this will be the when steam is what? Wet. This is the steam is what? Wet steam. This will be for dry and saturated steam. And if steam is superheated, we can see. What will be changed? Nothing changed, only tier diagram. Again, basic concentration we have to go for. This is our saturated curve. Okay. Then this is our boiler pressure line. Now I am here. So this will be again boiler condenser pressure. Okay. So this is a boiler pressure, pre-boiler. Okay. Then point number superheated steam means point number one will be in the, this is a superheated genus. So this will be superheated one. So point number one from 1 to 2 there will be heat addition 1 to 2. This process will be happens in steam turbine. Okay, and 2 to 3 is there, it is going to be heat rejection.
Hello. आज बोलतोय त्यांना काय त्यांचे ते क्युअर झालं पाहिजे म्हणते
in 1 to superheated steam, 1 to 2 steam turbine, 1 to 2 will be this, 2 to 3 will be in the condenser process. And then 3 to 4 is happens in pump. So only this now, there is change in only the heat addition process. So 4 to 1 sensible heat is latent heat and this is a superheat. So this 4 to 1 entire process, so sensible, latent and superheated happens in the boiler. So this is only change for a superheated steam. So this is a case for dry and saturated steam, this is for wet steam, and this is for superheated steam. Everybody understood this? I want to make a reply from your side. I want to reply. Understood? Nikhil Pawar, yes sir. Okay. Then shall I continue next? Anybody having doubt? Please unmute and ask. So yes, sir. Gorakh Shinde, doubt is there or understood? No problem. Okay. So I want message from everybody. Everybody, you have to make practice of these tier diagrams when cycle is when steam entering to the turbine. That is, remember here, steam entering to the turbine is wet, steam entering to the turbine is dry and saturated, or steam entering to the turbine is air superheated. Okay, I will ask some here randomly. Okay, SB Gorakshin, they understand, sir. Okay, SB Seven, Shraddha, are you in lecture? Understood, Swapnil, Swapnali Kalvurami. Okay, Shubham, Jyoti Patil. Are you in lecture?
Yes, sir.
understanding
yes, or sir. Understand.
Okay. Then Shoaib Molani.
Yes, sir.
Mari. Okay. Understanding any problem?
No, sir.
Okay. Nikhil Shinde. SB65. Tejasri Dongre. SB3.
Hi, yes, sir. Hi, yes, sir.
Understanding?
Hi, yes, sir. No problem.
Okay. Then Chaitanya Acharya.
Yes, sir.
Understanding?
Yes, sir.
Shall I continue next point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now last point we'll take today. So everybody getting this? This is a steam entering to the turbine is dry and saturated. The cycle will be this. We have to make this 4:1 visible now. These notes are visible now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this steam entering through the turbine is dry and saturated, first case. So this will be 4:1. This is boiler pressure line. This is condenser pressure line. Point number one is now dry and saturated, therefore on vapor line. Okay. Then 1:2 will be complete isentropic expansion in steam turbine. Then 2:3 complete condensation in condenser. 3:4 pump isentropic compression in pump. And then boiler processes. 4:2 this sensible heat, latent heat, okay, only this much. If it is steam is supplying to the superheated, then only change is there in the point number 1 and 2 will only change. So one is what? It is going on the superheated. This is a constant pressure line, but the point is in the superheated zone, 1:2. Okay. In HS diagram, okay, on only one diagram we have gone for. So HS diagram means enthalpy versus entropy. And this is called as Mollier diagram. HS diagram for Rankine cycle. Here again, this is a critical point, saturated liquid line, the saturated vapor line, and this is nothing but on HS diagram, constant pressure line is having this kind of nature. This is what? This kind of nature. Okay. Or I will draw in the presentation board there for everybody will understand. So HS diagram, if you want to draw. So this is now if you go this is nature of critical. This is actual nature critical point. This is liquid saturated liquid line. This is vapor line. And on HS diagram, nature of constant pressure line is like this. This is boiler pressure, we say. And this will be condenser pressure. Then this will be point number one. Let us consider dry and saturated steam. So this will be point number one. So this is nature of constant pressure on HS line. Here diagram the nature kasa hai? This is like this. Okay. 1 minute. Huh? Hello. Bol to aaj karoge ha. डॉक्टर काय म्हणले पुढील डॉक्टर कधी म्हणले म्हणले पुढील काय म्हणलं डॉक्टर नाही ना तुम्ही काय म्हण डॉक्टर
ऑक्सीजन लेवल वगैरह ओके है? ऑक्सीजन लेवल वगैरह ओके है? आता टेम्परेचर वगैरह काय दाखवलं? काय दाखवत नाही ना टेम्परेचर वगैरे काय. बोलतो आता राऊंड लागले डॉक्टरला पण विचारलं सोडा मग सांगा राऊंड लागले डॉक्टरला विचारलं सोडतो मी विचारू आता तुम्ही विचार राऊंड लागले डॉक्टरला आता मी विचार तुम्ही पण सांगा त्यांना आता आता राऊंडला घेतील की अजून सकाळी बर
So this is boiler pressure, this is condenser pressure, and this is now steam. Yes, dry and saturated steam is there. Let us consider one point is there. Okay, so point number 1 to 2 will be in the steam turbine. Condenser pressure to compare boiler pressure to condenser pressure is point number 2. Then 2 to 3 is there. Heat rejection in condenser. It is rejecting. So. We are getting complete condensation and 3 to 4 is isentropic again compression 3 to 4 this happens in pump this happens in boiler if point number 1 is in the wet region then only this will be dotted if I will show we can give as point number 1 dash 2 Point number will be 2 dash. Only change is there in this point, wet point. And if it is superheated, this will be like this: 1 double dash and 2 double dash. 1 double dash, 2 double dash. Superheat condition. 1 to 2 dry saturated point, and 1 to 2 will be here. It will be wet region, wet steam. Okay. Then like this, where diagram is there. HS diagram nature of constant pressure line is like this 4 to 1 one is dry and saturated 1 to 2 dash will be 1 to 2 dash for wet steam 1 double dash 2 double dash for superheated steam this is nature of HS diagram everybody understood or not I want answers
yes sir
okay so Now efficiency of Rankine cycle. So efficiency of Rankine cycle can be obtained as eta Rankine is equal to QS heat rejected minus heat work done means divided by heat supplied QS minus QR divided by QS. And now here enthalpy difference are there because pressure the process is at constant pressure, not at constant temperature. Therefore, here we say that efficiency of Rankine cycle QS is equal to H1 minus H4 means how much enthalpy is decreasing, specific enthalpy decreasing. That is nothing but what H1 minus H4. So here enthalpy is H1, okay, and here enthalpy is H4. So difference H1 minus H4. Or if it is wet steam is there H1 dash minus H4. If it is a superheated steam H1 double dash minus H4. So H1 minus H4 is a enthalpy drop. I mean enthalpy here work heat supplied. If 4 to 1 साठी जाण्यासाठी किती हीट लागणार त्याला तर इथं H4 एन्थालपी असेल इथं H1 असेल तर इट इज इन बॉयलर हीट सप्लाइड हाउ मच इट हॅज टेकन H1 मायनस H4 सो इट विल बी H1 मायनस H4 हीट रिजेक्टेड किती असणार H2 मायनस H3 जास्त मायनस कमी घ्यायचं H2 मायनस H3 डिफरन्स शुड कम पॉझिटिव्ह सो हीट सप्लाइड H1 मायनस H4 हीट रिजेक्टेड H2 मायनस H3 अँड रिटा रँकिन इज कमिंग एज H1 मायनस H4 मायनस H2 मायनस H3 डिवाइडेड बाय H1 मायनस H4 This way we can calculate the heat efficiency of Rankine. So we should know the enthalpies H1, H2, H3, H4, and from that we can calculate efficiency of Rankine cycle. Efficiency of Rankine cycle can also be defined as ratio of work obtained from the cycle to the heat supplied, or net work we can say net work divided by heat supplied. Net work means steam turbine work minus pump work because turbine is developing work, pump is taking work. So W turbine minus W pump. So H1 minus H2 again. Pump or the turbine, how much it is developing? H1 and H2. Is that the difference? it means they work were developed, and compressor la H4 minus H3. So here it will be W steam turbine minus W pump divided by heat supplied QS. Therefore H1 minus H2 and pump work H4 minus H3. So this is the eta ranking efficiency we can calculate. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So yes. Okay. Now actual ranking cycle. What is change in so what we'll do? We'll stop here because too much we have taken today. Now I want to request you that I am putting this PDF copy on our group so that you can study this once more. And next lecture, maybe today or tomorrow, or not tomorrow, but here maybe next lecture, we will complete the actual ranking cycle, effect of operating conditions on ranking cycle efficiency. Okay, then we'll complete this unit also. So shall we stop today, or shall we take more? You tell. Accordingly, we'll go for. Anybody who want to stop, they can write message, sir. Yes, sir. Those who doesn't want to stop, want to continue, say no or continue first. If you are not in trading, I will not consider your attendance, sir.
Bas sir.
Bas, bas. Attendance considered. Okay. Yes, sir means continue or what? Okay. Continue. Prem Chauhan. Very good. Nikhil Sindhi. Yes means what? Here, stop. Okay. Stop, sir. Okay. So, what Chauhan, many students are telling stop, so we'll stop today. Shivam, okay. Shantanu, yeah, stop, sir. Thank you. Okay. So, then I will take attendance and